Welcome to the Grower Pesticide Safety Course, Chapter 3, the Pesticide Label. Chapter 3 starts on page 33 of the manual, and there are 20 slides in this presentation. It will take you about 15 minutes to review. Let's get started. Pesticide Label. What will I learn? By the end of this lesson, you should be ready to identify the information you will find on a pesticide label. List the information found on each part of the label. Identify and interpret the hazard symbols and the signal words. Read the label. A pesticide label gives important information. It tells you how to use the product safely, how to use the product legally, what to do if there is an accident. The pesticide label is a legal document. The pesticide label shows it is registered by the Pest Management Regulatory Agency, Health Canada. It gives the name and address of the company that makes the pesticide. Pesticide labels are online. Search the keywords Pesticide Labels Health Canada and you should come to the site. And there's also an app available now to download on your mobile device. You can always be connected to the pesticide label. Principal display panel. There are two main parts to a pesticide label. The front panel is called the principal display panel. The back side or side panel is called the secondary display panel. And this chapter will tell you what information you can find on each panel. Look at the sample label as we go through it in the chapter in your manual or here on the screen with me. The product name. The product name includes three things. The product name approved by the PMRA and may include a trade name or brand name. Pest Manager 500EC is the name of this product. The physical form of the pesticide, the formulation, is there. In this case, the product is a liquid, an emulsifiable concentrate, EC. And description of its purpose, this product is a herbicide used to control weeds. Classification or risk. This tells you the federal class to which a product has been assigned and indicates who can use the product. Therefore, we have classifications that are domestic. Homeowners can use this product. They're sold usually in smaller packages and have a lower toxicity. Commercial or agricultural, could also say institutional. They're designed to use in commercial operations in agriculture, forestry, industry, and must be handled carefully and restricted. The safety of these products for plants and animals or the environment is still a concern. They have special detailed labels to know how to handle them safely, and sometimes they need a permit. Net contents. This tells you how much of the product is in the package. The amount is shown in metric. This label shows there are 10 liters in this package. This is important when you go to measure and apply the right amount. Mode of action. Mode of action grouping and identification symbol. Pesticides are divided into groups according to the way they work to control the pest. This is called mode of action. You can use the group number to plan your pesticide rotation and help manage the development and slow the development of pesticide resistance. Going further on the principal display panel, you're going to find read the label before using. This warning must be on the front panel. It's required by the regulations of the Pest Control Products Act. Precautionary symbols and words. The Pest Control Products regulations contain symbols and words to show how hazards of using the pesticides. There might be an allergen statement found on this area of the primary panel. And all these symbols and words and what they mean are described a little bit later. The guarantee. The guarantee tells you the common name of the chemical and its active ingredient in the product. The active ingredient is the part of the pesticide product that controls the pest. There are more than one active ingredient in a pesticide product. In each case, the more than one common name will appear there. So it'll include the concentration, how much of the chemicals in the product. It could be by weight per volume or percentage by weight. The PCP Act registration number. This number shows the product has been registered by PMRA Health Canada. The registration number identifies the product to the government and the manufacturer. And finally, the registrant name and address. And this is the company, the business that is selling the product. And you can always phone or ask for more information about the product from the registrant. The secondary display panel, the back or side of the pesticide, the finer print of the pesticide. It has some specific areas as well. First, the directions for use will be on the secondary display panel, and that'll include things like which pests, which crops or livestock, how much to use, how much to mix, how to apply, and the pre-harvest and restricted entry intervals. Those are lots of things under directions for use. Also, on the secondary display panel, we have precautions. This section tells you what hazards there are in using and handling the pesticide product, including what protective clothing and personal protective equipment to wear. It tells you how to use it safely, how to protect the environment, yourself, and others from danger. There may be a separate environmental hazard section, and you will always find the child hazard warning, keep out of reach of children here, on restricted and agricultural class products. Disposal is also in this secondary display panel, and this section tells you how to dispose of the container safely. First aid tells you what to do when someone is poisoned or injured by the pesticide, and you are the first person to help. Every label states, take container, label, or product name and pest control registration number with you when seeking medical attention. Toxicological information gives more information on the signs and symptoms of poisoning. It tells the doctor what antidote to use and any ingredients that may influence the treatment. Notice to user, this section tells the person using the product to follow the directions on the label. Make sure that you follow the directions. It's against the law to use a pesticide in an unsafe way, and the buyer is responsible for the safe use of that pesticide. The hazard symbols and words. Learn these symbols and words. They could save your life. So what are the hazards? Four of them: poison, corrosive, flammable, and explosive. And the border shapes and signal words. The hazard symbol will always appear inside one of the border shapes shown. These shapes and their associated signal words will tell you the degree of hazard of the pesticide. The greater the number of sides, the more hazardous the product. Example, what does this combination mean? Danger, poison. And we have an eight-sided shape. And if we check in our manual, there's a table on page 41. This symbol could be on the label because the acute oral LD50 is less than 500 milligrams per kilogram, or the acute dermal LD50 is less than 500 milligrams per kilogram, or the acute inhalation LC50 is less than 1.05 milligrams per liter of air. So checking the chart on page 41, you can see under any of those instances, that's when danger poison would be on the label. Highly acutely toxic. There's also special warnings for eye hazards, eye and skin hazards. For the eyes, we have danger corrosive to eyes, warning eye irritant, caution eye irritant. When you see any of those, it might be a good idea to put goggles on to make sure you don't get anything in your eyes when using the product. Some products can be dangerous to your skin and are skin sensitizers. They're increasingly severe responses after prolonged and repeated uses of the product. So you're looking for words on the label such as danger, skin irritant, warning, skin irritant, caution, skin irritant. Restricted products. Look for special directions on restricted products or products classified as commercial with a restricted use. If a product has been classified as restricted, the label must have a section called Nature of Restriction at the top of the secondary display panel. And enclosed in a box and before the directions. Here's an example. Exposure to this product may be hazardous to your health. Care must be taken when handling to minimize exposure. Follow all label directions and precautions carefully. This product is only to be used by individuals holding an appropriate pesticide applicator certificate or license recognized by the Provincial Territorial Pesticide Regulatory Agency where the pesticide application is to occur. Other label statements. So we're still looking on the secondary display panel, and we're going to find pre-harvest, pre-grazing, pre-slaughter statements. And this is based on the results from food residue studies and the setting of the maximum residue limits by Health Canada. So we have a pre-harvest interval, and that would be the amount of time that must pass between the last pesticide application and the harvesting the plants or the grazing or cutting of the livestock feed. Pre-grazing interval, the amount of time that must pass between the pesticide application and the grazing of animals on that crop. And pre-slaughter interval, the amount of time that must pass between treatment of the animal with the pesticide and slaughter of the animal. Failure to do any of this would result in residues left in the crop or animal. Always check the dates. Pesticide residues break down during the time between the end of the application and when you are allowed to harvest, slaughter, graze. Once the period has ended, the pesticide residues are below the maximum residue limits allowed on the food. Maximum residue limits are set by Health Canada for each pesticide applied to each food. On we go to restricted entry intervals. Restricted entry interval is the period of time after a pesticide has been applied that agricultural workers or anyone else must not do hand labor tasks in treated areas. Examples. Here we have pesticide matador. The restricted entry interval is 24 hours for all crops on that label. Scala SC. 24 hours for hand thinning on apples. 24 hours for hand labor on grapes. 12 hours for other crops and tasks. So they can differ within each label. Switch 62.5 wettable granule, 10 days for hand harvest and hand pruning on Saskatoon berries, 12 hours for other crops and tasks. So look for each one by crop and also the task that has to be done. Note, if the REI is not stated on the label, use a 12-hour REI. Early entry from the restricted entry interval. Certified farmers, farmer assistants, or workers may need to enter a treated area early to do short-term tasks before the end of an REI, and this is allowed if you follow these guidelines. For example, a 24-hour REI is here. 0 to 4 hours, you do not enter. The end of the application is the start of the 24-hour restricted entry interval. No one can enter that area from 0 to 4 hours. But when we get to the 4-hour to 12-hour period, early entry can be made by certified farmers. You must not do hand labor tasks. You must only be in the area for less than 1 hour and 24 hours. And you must wear the protective clothing stated on the label for mixing and loading, plus wearing a NIOSH approved respirator. Okay, if you get to the 12 to 24 hours and you need to go in early, early entry can happen by workers, but they must not do the hand labor tasks. They must not contact any of the surfaces that have residues. And again, wear protective clothing and personally protective equipment items if those are stated on the label for early entry. And finally, we get to our 24 hours and anyone can enter. It's the end of the REI on the label. Anyone may enter. Tell farm workers and others of the REIs. Notify your farm manager, farm worker, scouts, others of the restricted entry intervals. Everyone needs to know. One way to do this is to post signs, such as the one example shown here, at any of the main ways into the treated area. These signs are available from the pesticide education program. In addition to posting signs, keep spray records and REIs in a location where they can be readily seen and read by farm workers or anyone else on the farm. Buffer zones. What is a buffer zone? It is an area that you leave untreated to protect sensitive habitats. Buffer zone is the distance between the point of application of the pesticide and the closest downwind edge of the sensitive area to the pesticide. Sensitive terrestrial areas, that would include grasslands, forestry areas, shelter belts, woodlots, and sensitive freshwater habitats. And include lakes, rivers, ponds, marshes, streams. Again, how is the buffer zone measured? Measure the distance between the point of application and the nearest downwind edge of the sensitive area. When you tank mix, check the label for each pesticide. Use the largest buffer zone listed. Supplemental labels. If a new use has been just registered, the new information may not be on that currently printed label, and new information such as approval to use a pesticide as a temporary or emergency use, or a new use that's been expanded to include more crops or pests. So there could be additional label information, and your crop specialist will certainly be aware of that. You must follow all the information on both the supplemental label and the registered product label when you use the product. Pesticide use in high tunnels. Pesticide labels don't have specific direction for use in high tunnels. In high tunnels, you may use pesticides with directions for either greenhouse or field uses. If possible, choose a pesticide with directions for both field and greenhouse use. A high tunnel environment is unique. Pesticide residues could break down more slowly, crops could be injured more easily, and certified applicators and farmer assistants could have increased exposure. So take precautions. Reduce your exposure, wear the most protective clothing equipment, or use a closed cab. Use the longest REI and pre-harvest intervals on the label. Test a pesticide for a possibility of crop injury, maybe on a small area before treating the whole crop that's under a high tunnel. The pesticide label. Read all of the label each year and read the current label. Read the booklet and any additional information attached. We have a little tutorial on our website. If you need some practice finding information on labels, you can take a few minutes to do this tutorial. That's a quick review of the Chapter 3, the Pesticide Label. Try the practice questions at the end of the chapter. Plus, also, there's a label quiz using an example label in the manual, and it'll be similar to some of the questions you'll be asked on the test about the pesticide label. Know where things are in the pesticide label so you can look them up quickly and know where to find them in each of the sections.